Billy Meyer also has metal samples that he claims demonstrate signs of extraterrestrial manufacturing. This is that metal. The metal sample contained nearly every element in the periodic table, Vogel stated. Each pure element was bonded to each of the others, yet somehow retained its own identity. At 500x magnification, thulium was revealed. At 1600x, there are structures within structures, and at 2500x magnification, the sample was metal, but at the same time, it is crystal. Now, this is an image of a diatom. It's a type of phytoplankton at 5000x magnification. Even using magnification far greater than what Marcel Vogel used when he did his examination, it is still impossible to view the elemental or atomic structure of an object using a scanning electron microscope. The resolution of the scanning electron microscope is simply not high enough to image down to that level. In fact, increasing the magnification of any object using any form of microscope will not tell you what the object is made of. The only way to determine the composition of an object is to use a process such as gas chromatography, mass spectrometry. Meyer and his followers point to Marcel Vogel's analysis as another form of proof that Meyer has been in contact with extraterrestrials.
When he analyzed the metal samples, he detected the presence of thulium and other rare elements and gases in the metal samples by using spectral analysis, the standards for doing such.
With any technology that I know of could not achieve this on this Earth plane. I could not explain the type of material that I have and its discreteness by any known combination of materials. I could not put it together myself.
The elements that we found were totally surprising. The major element, which is shown here, was the rare earth metal thulium, THULIUM. It was totally unexpected. So now we've seen silicon, iron, thulium, silver, and copper, all in a specimen about this big.
When he examined the metal under electron scanning microscope, he then found the micromachining, which was a clear evidence to him that this was a deliberately manufactured product.
We found evidence of what looks like mechanical manipulation. One sees now discrete marks in a diagonal form in this direction and marks in this direction. But what is exciting, it looks like it's been plowed. In other words, a pressure, and there is a scarfing on either side.
Do we know what this metal is used for?
We're told that these metals were representative of a number of the different stages, seven stages of manufacturing that the Pleiaren go through to create the metal for their spacecraft.
Billy Meyer also has an audio recording of what he claims is the sound of one of the extraterrestrial spaceships. It is these eight inaudible frequencies that Meyer and his followers use to point out the extraterrestrial nature of these audio recordings. The complete range of human hearing is from 15 hertz to 20,000 hertz. So no audio cassette tape recorder, nor any audio cassette tape, can record any frequencies outside the range of human hearing. Doesn't have any merit because the analysis done of this audio was in error.
What's happening is the 10 different frequencies are converging on one central frequency, which is, I find, very interesting. This is probably one of the most interesting things about the tape, is that there are...
What's this right now?
Very, very many tones.
Yeah.
And they're all changing very fast.
Not synthesizers on the market that have oscillators that change that randomly. Even if you got 9 or 10 of them going, they wouldn't change from those peaks that quickly.
So a significant thing is this rate of change.
And besides, if you were going to create a noise for a spaceship, you'd be hard put to come up with something as original as this.
In the original preliminary investigation report done on this case, eight different sound engineers had the opportunities to analyze the sounds on oscilloscopes and spectrum analyzers. These included three different laboratories, including U.S. Naval Undersea Labs. They could find no sound source of record that could produce these sounds. 24 were indeed in the audible range. The 8 inaudible sounds were determined through the calculations in a formula based on the existing sounds. To date, even with synthesizers, nobody has been able to duplicate the sounds which we make freely available to anybody who wants to try.
So this next prophecy is one that Meyer and his followers claim is the best case example demonstrating the accuracy of his predictions and therefore the ultimate proof that he is in contact with extraterrestrials. And the prophecy reads, "The danger of accidents in nuclear reactors will increase throughout the world. Regarding this subject, France in particular must be extraordinarily careful in every way, for one prophecy warns of a strong probability for an accident near Lyon." Now, the first thing to be aware of is how vague the actual prophecy is. It doesn't say that there will be an accident at a nuclear reactor near Lyon, only that there might be one at some point in the future. However, in 2005, Michael Horn stated that this prediction actually came true. In August of 2003, the world was having the worst heat wave in recorded history. France received 75% of its electrical power from nuclear power stations, such as the Bouguer power station, located on the Rhône River near Lyon. Nuclear power plants use the river water to cool the reactors and then release the heated water back into the river. French environmental regulations state that the maximum temperature that the water released back into the river can be is 24 degrees centigrade. The reason being that if warmer water were to be released back into the river, it could damage the plant and animal life of the river. This prophecy is one that Meyer and his followers have publicly stated to be the best case example of his accurate ability to see the future. Not only was the plant not shut down in August of 2003, there never was any discussion of shutting the plant down. All of the discussions were on how to keep the plant generating as much electricity as possible.
When I first saw the article, I was immediately reminded of Meyer's prophecy regarding this specific nuclear power plant, which was one of 432 on the planet at the time. This prompted me to do more research. We found that article on the internet. It actually preceded the article from 2003 that showed the recent shutdown of that plant. The article from 2000 was even more telling. They foresaw tremendous damage had the repairs not been made at that time. Perhaps the most startling of what I call the prophetically accurate information in the Meyer case pertains to Meyer's astronomical information about numerous planets, but especially Jupiter, its rings, its moons. Meyer specifically said that Io was the most volcanically active body in the solar system. He published that 5 months before we discovered it. More than a year after he published the information on a ring of Jupiter being composed of ionized sulfur particles, Science magazine published that information in January of 1980. Most impressively, when I sent Meyer's information about Io being the most volcanically active body in the solar system, as published by Meyer 5 months before the probe got there, Professor Joseph Viverka, the head of the astronomy department at Cornell University, said the following to me, and I quote, "If he, Meyer, said that 3 to 6 months before, then all I can say is that he was right."
A lot of times people ask skeptics and other scientific organizations to prove that something is a hoax. It's actually not possible to do, because the only person who can call something a hoax legitimately is the person who perpetrated it.
You would say in your best judgment that what he's used are models. That's
yes. Okay. There's nothing wrong with the idea of there being life outside of our solar system and life within the galaxy. It's just that so far, Meyer has not presented any evidence to show that any extraterrestrial life has come here that stands up under legitimate scientific scrutiny.
There are numerous scientists and experts who have examined, analyzed, and authenticated Meyer's physical evidence. including such stellar personalities as Michael Malin from NASA and the Mars mission. We have sound engineers, photographic and film experts, special effects experts, physicists, and numerous professional facilities at which the physical evidence was examined and authenticated. Again, people are going to have to take a look at that for themselves and decide whether or not it's convincing to them.